One approach is a window-based algorithm. In this approach, a sender can only have a certain number of packets outstanding or, quote, in flight, and the sender uses acknowledgments from the receiver to clock the retransmission of new data. So let's suppose that the sender's window was 4 packets. At this point, there are 4 packets outstanding in the network, and the sender cannot send additional packets until it has received an acknowledgment from the receiver. When it receives an acknowledgment or an ACK from the receiver, the sender can then send another packet. So at this point, there are still 4 outstanding or 4 unacknowledged packets in flight. In this case, if a sender wants to increase the rate at which it's sending, it simply needs to increase the window size. So for example, if the sender wants to send at a faster rate, it can increase the window size from 4 to 5. A sender might increase its rate anytime it sees an acknowledgement from the receiver. In TCP, every time a sender receives an acknowledgement, it increases the window size. Upon a successful receipt, we want the sender to increase its window by 1 packet per round trip. So for example, in this case, if the sender's window was initially 4 packets, then at the end of a single round trip's worth of sending, we want the next set of transmissions to allow 5 packets to be outstanding. This is called additive increase. If a packet is not acknowledged, the window size is reduced by half. This is called multiplicative decrease. So TCP's congestion control is called additive increase multiplicative decrease, or AIMD. The other approach to adjusting rates is an explicit rate-based congestion control algorithm. In this case, the sender monitors the loss rate and uses a timer to modulate the transmission rate. Window-based congestion control, or AIMD, is the common way of performing congestion control in today's computer networks. In the next lesson, we will talk about the two goals of TCP congestion control further, efficiency and fairness, and explore how TCP achieves those goals.